What's up, guys? Figure I'd hop on here and make a video of some raking. Just washed the tractor and rake. Turn the volume up a little bit here. Think you're gonna get out and look and see what our silo's doing. Is anything? Okay, 18% fermenting. Still have a ways to go on that. Which is fine. So, I haven't tried this rake on alfalfa, so I'm kind of curious to see what will happen. Because it teds and it merges, so I guess we'll find out together. Start off by opening it up. Seems like it. Just mix it alfalfa. So now that we know that, we'll kind of looks like it's doing some tedding, but I guess we'll see what our bales look like. Might need to add some lines in the XML for alfalfa. So it's nice to use a rake. I've never used a rake before in FarmSim. Made my merger, and that's I'm still pretty partial to the merger, but it's nice to kind of get a little bit less expensive piece of equipment to do the merging. Just lift this up. we're missing a few spots on our alfalfa. Probably do two headland passes. Our spacing was off over here. This is removing our planet alfalfa. Wow, there's 46 people in the chat right now. Everyone's saying hello. No, this rake, I haven't released this rake yet, so it's still private. This game always has issues with windrows, picking up windrows and stuff. I noticed that on multiplayer too. It's sometimes when you rake stuff or merge stuff, it kind of disappears. So I'm assuming if I save the game and reload, it's going to reappear. I mean, that was the case on multiplayer. I mean, I never had this issue on my Wind Chaser map, so. I'm using my same wheel lanes mod, so I'm not real. I'm just sure what's going on. I only watched like a first impression of 17 for like maybe 5 minutes. Mostly because I don't really care, and I honestly I can't stand listening to other like farm sim YouTubers talk. It drives me bananas. So when I get my version, I'll probably do my own series and I'll actually look at it in depth. Take a look at mod descriptions, take a look at the actual i3D models, take a look at the XML, see what's actually changed. A more in-depth, less arcadey. So I mean, everyone's gonna be like, oh my god, you can harvest, the wagons can tip, you know, that's great, but I'm more interested in seeing the actual scripting changes. And a modder's perspective, not just, you know, playing the game, because the game as is, without mod scripts, it's just too painful to play. So, and I'd like to start working on converting my equipment over. So, see how easy that will be to do that. First thing I noticed is like all the equipment, all the tractors look like the same. They all have the same hitch design on everything. They use the same front hitch on 90% of the tractors and stuff. But I like to see there's a lot of new things that aren't in 15, because 15 doesn't have the scripts, you know, it's not a part of the game, like refilling with bags of seed or liquid fertilizer. I'm curious what happens with those, if you have to keep buying it or if you can refill it. Because that'd be great for like seed boxes and stuff like that. You can actually go buy some liquid fertilizer, fill it up, put it on a flatbed trailer or something. Make a little smaller tender that only holds a couple units of seed, a couple hundred units of seed. Kind of curious how, because I know in the dealership you have the ability to kind of like change the horsepower and like change wheel configurations and stuff like that, so I'm kind of curious to see how difficult that will be. A lot of my mods are already designed for that with decals and, you know, spare parts XMLs, so it shouldn't be too much of a hassle to script those properly for 17. Be real nice if I can get rid of all the buyable wheel scripts, and it'd be nice if I can get rid of indoor sound scripts, and it'd be nice if I can get rid of seat suspension and cab suspension, if that's all part of the core game. Because a lot of those scripts are the ones that have issues, cause compatibility issues. Am I gonna buy 17? I've already purchased it. I was reading that land roller they have in game. It doesn't actually do it. It removes field terrain, is what it does. So like this field terrain will turn into grass. Like it will get rid of the field terrain. Which is interesting, I guess, but I mean, it's kind of like magic. So yeah, it's leaving some funky spots in the field. That didn't happen before when I was doing grass, so we'll see what happens with our grass, I guess. Start up over here. Yeah, so this will make hay. So we took out a couple rows of our bales, probably about two rows. We were making silage and we chopped up a bunch of our hay for our commodity shed so we can make feed. I thought that was an alfalfa field earlier. It's actually oats, so we didn't have as much planted as I thought we did, which I guess is a good thing. I didn't feel like collecting 500 bales. If I can. Actually, I think this line is good. Because we actually mowed this a little bit short from the field across the road, so we'll keep that one. I think that's good. I'll start harvesting crops, obviously, when they're ready, but as you can see, they're not ready to be harvested, so I think that'd be kind of a logical. Anyways, in my last video, I was talking about YouTube channels, and someone mentioned Minnesota Millennial Farmer, and I started watching his videos, and I have to say, they're really good. I really enjoy watching those. Does a really good job at explaining what he's up to, or what they're doing. I picked this up, and then just go across the street here. Do our headlands a little bit later. So I think after I'm done baling everything, I think I'm gonna end up maybe broadcasting some dry nutrients and tilling up these fields and replanting and like making different field contours, get a little bit better spacing on these fields. Rent a small planter and plant in some grass, you know, dividers. So our grass isn't leaving any patches like our alfalfa was. Interesting. come down here and pick up a line. See, now when I rake the grass, it doesn't leave any. So I know it's not my rake. It's the actual crop itself. So we're in the 175. It's a little big of a tractor for this, but gotta use what you have. Figured we'd use this tractor since we used our 6215, put a few hours on that mowing all the grass, so might as well even out the hours. Nice feature in 17 is you're gonna have to do maintenance, or maintenance will increase, or cost of ownership or something like that's gonna increase as equipment gets older. As I'm sure what they mean is like hours of operation. The more hours you have on it, it's probably like a weighted scale or something like that. And it sounded like you'll have to do repairs or maintenance. I'm not sure if that's like an automatic thing or if you actually have to manually fix up. Kind of like a built-in repairs mod. Which would be cool. I'm sure there isn't a day that goes by that you don't have to fix or repair something on the farm. So I feel like that should be a significant component of the game itself. I don't know about you guys, but I'm ready for this week to be over with. Just feels like the days now are just so exhausting. If you're not an adult yet, don't grow up. That's my warning. Avoid growing up. Because adulting sucks. Anyways, looking at some of the new features in FS kind of has my brain going with ideas of things that were kind of for show in 15. Like, you have the ability to have fertilizer in seed. Like, think about this. You can have the ability of a tillage tool to do a to be not only tillage but spraying. But you don't have to add any sprayer capacity. You can hook up like an anhydrous tank to it. That the tank isn't a sprayer, it's just a tank. So you can actually be more realistic with the ability of laying down fertilizer as you do tillage, say like a chisel plow. You're chisel plowing in, you know, potassium and phosphorus. You know, so a lot of these things will. Make it a little bit easier to be a little bit more realistic with how you script mods and use mods, and actually allows the, you know, an opportunity to actually make mods now that they would have function and not just for show. Kind of curious to see how the straps, because now you can like strap down bales and stuff on trailers, so I'm kind of curious to see how they actually designed that and coded that and how the scripting is, because I know if you wanted to like add straps to stuff in 15, you physically have to like place your straps in GE. I'm wondering if this is a little bit smarter or if it's that same method. A lot of unknowns. That's really why I want to get at and look at the XMLs and really look at the i3Ds. And see what we're working with. And now that the silos have capacities, and you can actually buy additional silos, I feel like it'll be a lot easier to maybe set these up with different triggers for like augers and stuff like that. But who really knows? I'm not sure because I haven't really watched, but I'm curious if there's multiple, like say for cows and you know 1315, there's only been one navigation mesh, and if you try to make two separate navigation meshes they get stuck on the side. So I'm wondering if you have the ability to have multiple navigation meshes for animals. Well, that'd be really great, because if you're gonna buy and move animals and stuff, it'd be great if you can like move them from one pasture to another. Okay, we're kind of at an awkward. Awkward part. Whatever, we'll just go here and just kind of zigzag. I haven't really been reading the comments. Gotta catch up. Do I use a light mod? What is that? I'm not really sure what that means. The only mod I use for lighting is the one that Sirius Mods converted and released, realistic night or daylight mod or whatever it is. That's all I use. Have I released my stuff? Yeah, I have a link in the video, in my videos. All my stuff I've released, I put on ModHoster and ModHoster only. How much am I gonna do today? I have no idea. I modify to get it. Basically, I just doubled up working area and drop areas. Because in XML, I'll always say like work area windrower, drop area windrower. And then so then I just kind of used the same lines and added a tether function. And obviously the tether function will only work with, if you look at the core scripts, it's only gonna ted grass. It won't ted anything else. Where my windrower, it will merge whatever you drive over. Straw, grass, oat, alfalfa. But the tether function only works with grass. Nothing else. Unless you rewrite, you know, export it and rewrite it a little bit. But I think our alfalfa won't be hay, it will be grass. I'm not positive. I might look into adjusting that. See if I can fiddle around. I know our alfalfa yields like half a liter or a liter more per square meter than grass. One thing I was surprised to see was they had the Great Plains planter, but it's just this little thing, like completely worthless. You know, I'm sure people have gardens bigger than what you use that planter in. But of all things, you know, manufactured by Great Plains, they went with this tiny little planter. It's like this little drill. Of all the epic pieces of equipment they could have built, they went with a little planter that I will never use. Unless I start farming with a lawnmower or something. I also haven't heard or seen anything. Have they changed up the traffic splines, or if the traffic's still indestructible? Be kind of nice if they made the traffic a little bit more flexible, a little bit smarter. You know, kind of how it was in 13. Still have no idea why they ever changed that. Literally, the traffic spline has nothing to do with any changes they made, but I guess we'll never know. Yeah, there's like legit people that like think farming simulators like lawn care simulator, which I mean that's I guess that's one of the addicting aspects of this game is it's a giant sandbox. You can make it and shape it and do whatever you want with it, but not that fun to mow grass in this game with, say, like a 52-inch deck mower or whatever they are, 42-inch. Although they do make some badass zero-turn mowers these days, like my dad was—he just bought a new John Deere lawnmower. Some of the zero turns are they're like $12,000 or whatever for a mower. Obviously, unless you have a hay field for a yard, you're not going to use something like that. Or if you're a commercial mower. But my dad retired last April. He bought up some farmland as kind of a retirement investment, leased to farmers, and then they just bought a new lake house. It was 4 acres, and so he bought a new lawnmower. I guess it's pretty badass. When you're old, that's like the highlight of your day is a new lawnmower, I guess. I wonder how handy that you can now grab things and like move stuff around. I wonder how useful that's going to be. I mean, really, what are you going to use that for? Besides like moving little pieces of wood around. I mean, can you like shovel grain out of pile? I don't know like really what the whole point is. I might have to knock down how quick this. I have a work multiplier of 10 on this rake, and it seems to be getting a little too dirty, a little too fast compared to my tractor. Like, obviously, it should get dirtier quicker than the tractor because it's working, but not that dirty. With all these new brands and equipment and different tractors, I think one nice thing is going to be to see if there's any improvement in the sound files, because literally like everything in Farm Sim sounds the same. So it'll be nice to see if they have any more low frequency beefy sounds or actual authentic sounds and stuff like that. Because that's kind of a pet peeve of mine is, you have a really good tractor, it looks really great, it functions really well, and then the sound is off, or it's not, you know, there's sort of like, even the sound on this thing isn't, I'm not happy with it, but know, the sound, how you adjust the pitch, and I don't know. I don't understand that stuff very well. But I'm hoping they have some nice updated sound files. Yeah, there's like people that are like preview partners, and that's with everything. I think they go for the bigger channels that have, you know, 20 plus thousand subscribers. Like, I understand, like, that can get, like, people excited for it, but for someone like myself, I'm not even, I watched it for maybe 10, 15 minutes, and I'm like, this is ridiculous. I'll wait and do my own exploring. It's coming out like what, next week or something? So I mean, I can wait. I just know once I start playing it, I'm probably going to become consumed in converting all my mods over to 17. And so I'm kind of dreading all that work that's to come. When I have so much I want to do for 15. So I'm going to be torn between converting mods to 17 and making new mods and scripting. Because once you script them in for 15 and get them set up for 15, it'll be cake to convert them over to 17, I'm imagining. But if you want to design a tractor that will be able to configure with different wheels and stuff like that, that's going to take a lot of reworking the XML. What happened in 13, the end of 13, is I upgraded. I had a GTX 460 graphics card. It was old when I built my computer. I built my computer back in 2010, I think. It's when I first built my computer. The only thing I have from that now is the same power supply. I have the same hard drive and the same water cooler and tower. And then I wanted to get a new graphics card, so I bought the GTX 970 when it came out, because my 460 was, you know, it was old when I bought it, but it was cheap. So I spent money, I got a 970, and then when I was installing it, my motherboard didn't support it. Like, I couldn't actually plug it into my motherboard. So I had to buy a new motherboard, and then when I bought that motherboard, my old i5's chip, when it wasn't, it was a different socket. So then I had to buy a new chip, and there was nothing wrong with my other chip. It was like an i5 $2,500K or whatever, and the thing just completely, I mean, this new one, I can't overclock this new chip at all. Like, it goes unstable. My other one I could overclock to like 4.2, and it was bone, you know, rock solid. So I was really pissed I had to, like, update to a new socket. Anyways, I installed the new motherboard, and then, the chip, and then I reinstalled my water cooler for the chip. Plugged in the graphics card, and then I went to start up, and I had, like, a boot loop. It was just a blue screen, and for whatever reason, my Windows on my hard drive, it makes no sense to me, but for whatever reason that got corrupt, and so I had to reinstall my Windows 7, and I lost all my mods and stuff like that, because I didn't have it backed up on a cloud server or anything like that, so it just was gone. And at that time, I believe FS15 was out for like a week or two or whatever it was. So that kind of forced me just to focus on 15, which I guess it was a good thing because it's a lot better than 13. Although my 13 game with all the mods and soil management and MMR, it was really good. Like, I was happy with it. I probably wouldn't have started playing 15 unless my Windows was corrupted. So that's kind of my sad progression to 15 from 13. I guess your best teacher is your last mistake. I back everything up, all my Blender work, all my mods. It's all backed up on a cloud server, which is nice. Don't have to worry about that, peace of mind. But also, if 17 turns out to be kind of a dud, meaning there isn't a whole lot of mod support out there for scripting and stuff like that, because I love my GPS, I need my GPS. Probably won't play much of 17 without GPS. Just some things I'm so used to and literally won't be able to play the game without. The only thing that would really kind of like solidify my decision to go like balls in on 17 is if the economy really is significantly improved. You know, selling a million liters of grain in an hour just, you know, makes for a good YouTube video, but isn't that realistic? And if the lighting, if I can have like three combines going in a field with cab light on, front lights on, pipe lights on, grain cart lights on, grain cart tractor truck lights, and they don't cancel each other out and create little black squares of weird shadow in the field, I'll probably be sold at that point, because that's the biggest weak link in 15 right now is the lights. They don't lag your game, because ever since they went to a caching system, it's all saved on your RAM and your graphics card. RAM, but still, it doesn't really work like real lights. Everything else, I don't really care. It's all kind of extra fluff. Won't make it or break it for me. Because other than those few things, you know, core game changes, everything else is basically 15 with mods, so. Though, there's a guy that released a mod, it was Upside Down, he's now part of Cattle and Crops. Same guy that did Drive Control and basically every global script we use. he released a mod in 15 for Track IR, and they have a new toy basically that will track your head and eye movements. And I'm kind of curious about that, because that would, the biggest reason why I don't get a steering wheel is because I like my mouse to look around and stuff like that. But if you had that Track IR, where you pretty much didn't really need a mouse anymore to like navigate and look around, I think that'd be really cool. I'm actually going to shut this down because I want to see what these alfalfa beds, what these alfalfa bales look like. I'm betting it's going to be a grass bale, not a hay bale. I'm just gonna wash this first. Moment of truth. So we ran 102 bales through this last on our first crop. Right now it's saying alfalfa. And it looks like it's grass bale? Or is it a hay bale? It is hay! Oh, you know what it is? It's because, actually, I don't really know. I'm assuming that because it alfalfa doesn't have like a dry alfalfa texture, it still considers it like tedded. But I'm not sure. I'm kind of happy though. It's hay. In the bale extension mod by Upside Down, shocker. It has the ability to adjust price multipliers on bales. So I'm figuring each bale of alfalfa was kind of looking at prices, but it was like 1200 or something if you don't do any modifications. So I bumped it down to a little bit more realistic price for a bale. So what we need to do is we need to increase this to 100. That does look nice though, that dry hay. I have the crop, the fruit view distance at 150. So can see a little bit further. I might kinda dick around with this baler a little bit more. See if I can add the net wrap, the cover edge from the 864. As far as I know, that was converted and it works. Maybe it doesn't, I don't know. I haven't actually used it. That way you can do variable bale sizes and then use up some net wrap. I was actually thinking of stockpiling bales along the road down here, but ended up just driving it all back to the farm. And since I built the dual bale forks, front the loader forks and the 3-point hitch, it should be easier to move more bales. So yeah, it's not liking picking up these windrows for this alfalfa at all. I wonder what the the new there's any new particles for balers. I know they updated what seems to be updated particles for the combines coming out the back end of it. Kind of curious to what else they changed. The crops, the shaders, they all look the same. They all kind of move the same, look the same. So I doubt they made any changes. They changed the soil texture. It's still flat though, not three-dimensional. Might look three-dimensional with the normal maps they use, but it's definitely flat. I'd like to see them implement the drying of grain, like corn, and before you put it in a silo. You know how you have to like compact your silage before you have to blanket it and it ferments? It'd be nice if they added kind of a moisture component, where like your crops would go bad if you left it in a silo at a high moisture, or if when you sell grain you'd get docked based on moisture. But that's it's giants we're talking about. Maybe a modder could do that somehow, someone a lot smarter than me. Sure, like, do over in Europe, like Germany and stuff, do they dry their grain? You never see them with the big grain legs and stuff and dryers and bins like you do. Even some Canadian farms, they just kind of put the grain in the bins and they don't dry it. Maybe they're just relying on fans, but I wonder if they even do that overseas. Someone's talking about silage. Yeah, silage. I just watched a quick glimpse, but it looks like a silage blade actually has function. I'm not sure what it does, if it's a shovel or not, but it looks like it kind of... it pushes stuff and it's kind of like dynamically moves with the blade, so maybe you can like push it into a big pile if you really wanted to. So I mean, these are the kind of things I want to try out on my own. That's why I'm not really watching any videos of people do this stuff, because I'd rather do it on my own for the first time and kind of get googly-eyed towards it, if it's cool or not. One thing I still believe is missing is like pesticide and fungicide. herbicide? Because to my knowledge, all it is fertilizer, right? That's all they have in the core game is fertilizer and only fertilizer. I mean, SimFarm back in like 95 had herbicide and pesticide and all that stuff. And they're just getting to the point where they're still not getting past the point of fertilizer, a different kind of fertilizer. And I'd be surprised if they ever did, because I mean, Giants really, they kind of like set in stone that they're gonna be more of an arcade kind of simulator. I mean, when you're on Game Boys, Nintendo, PlayStation, Xbox, PC, you're on phones, you know? It's mostly about harvest crops quick, sell it, plant, done. Which is unfortunate. Not sure what happened to the stream there, but I think it's funny that YouTube's live stream is still beta. It's been beta for like 2 years now. Like, I haven't seen any changes or improvements, and literally, like, everyone uses it. So, not sure what they're waiting for. So we're gonna get a decent amount of bales out of this little field. This windrow thing is bothering me. This is the, like, I would expect this on a dedicated server, but not in single player. I mean, my grass isn't doing it. I don't know what to say. I record all my videos with iAction. Forget how much I paid for it. I think it was like $30 or something. And it works great. Can film high quality video and it doesn't lag my computer at all. Or my internet. Although when I do live streaming, it kind of like uploads immediately to YouTube, So if I'm on the internet, like doing multiplayer or something like that, then it my game gets laggy. The only downside to iAction is I don't think it has the ability to like superimpose the like live chat or anything like that on over the screen. It's the only downside, I guess. I used to use MSI Afterburner, which is bizarre because it's an overclocking software that you can use to record. So bizarre. And that worked well. I forget why I stopped using it. I don't remember why. I mean, I don't have my graphics card overclocked or my CPU overclocked, so. I figure there's probably no real reason to do it. I'm not sure what other people use. Like you can watch other YouTube channels and they like have the chat like superimposed on the screen and all these weird things. I'm not really sure what software they use. Does it keep my watermark? I'm not really sure. I don't do any editing to my videos. It goes right from when I record it, gets uploaded right to YouTube. I don't do anything to it. The watermarks, I think there's like a little watermark you can add. It's like my channel part that's in every video. So I'm assuming if someone like downloads my video and tries to re-upload it, that it's gonna stay. I'm not really sure. I've seen a few people try to upload my video to their channels for whatever reason. So might as well go back to raking. Now that we know we can bail alfalfa. Someone's asking if I ever considered purchasing a steering wheel. Or the SATEC one from Giants, and I've considered it, but one, I just don't want my desk to be cluttered as hell, and two, you still need to use your mouse to like navigate and look around. So I'm a convenience guy, and I just don't really see the value of, like, a steering wheel would be great. Like, don't get me wrong, I'd love to have a steering wheel, but you still need to look around, and you still need to be able to click on stuff, and I just can't see me being happy with a steering wheel, always trying to reach for my mouse, and that's why I was talking about that track IR, and that, like, if it's good, might not need to use a mouse to kind of like look around and what you're doing, and you have buttons on a on the steering wheel to get in and out of vehicles and do all your functions and stuff like that. So I think if you had a track IR, that the new system that solves the issue of having to use a mouse. So I'm seriously considering. I don't really care how much it is. It's not about money. It's about convenience, and if my desk will look cluttered, and I don't want to keep plugging stuff and taking stuff on and off. So we shall see. I said message them and see if they want to send me one for free. Demo it. I'm under the assumption that Giants doesn't like me very much, because all I do is bash their game, so I doubt that would go over very well. Oh, Giants wheel is discontinued to poor quality? Wow, can't say I'm shocked. It looked like a cheap plastic piece of shit. $300 for that? Hard pass. Cool idea, cool panel. Never seen one of those before, but you didn't have to buy it to look at it. No, it was just terrible. I use Logitech mouse and keyboard, and I love my keyboard is like the K100 or something like that. It's got like the keys light up, the letters and numbers light up. And it's like a soft touch, it's like super quiet, doesn't make any noise. And the mouse I use is, let me see what it is, MX Performance. It's all wireless. About a really pricey Corsair headset, that's what I'm using right now. I think the microphone's pretty decent on it. Kind of has noise cancellation on and all those weird functions. I was looking at steering wheels probably a couple months ago, and there hasn't been anything new developed or released to my knowledge. Again, I'm not really like actively looking at the stuff, but I feel like how many people are into computer games now, and but then again, you know, a lot of the major games that are being released aren't like driving or NASCAR, it's like war game or personal shooter, or you know, strategy games. Like, if there's one company I could see, like, doing a steering wheel, it would be, like, SCS for Truck Sim. I'm surprised that hasn't happened. should I move it over? That's nice and quiet. I like that. So, I don't really know much about rakes. I'm not even sure how nice this rake is that I made compared to like other ones, like Kuhn or someone else, but it looked badass and it's goes good with my John Deere, so. Nice thing would be is if they kind of redid the Satech steering wheel controller and like actually made it quality for that price. At that price, you know, the whole thing should have been $50, really, and that would be probably too much based on the material they used. But it'd be nice, like the joystick, if you could like raise and lower headers and extend your auger on your combine, push of a button kind of stuff. Like, that'd be cool. But that would actually be really fun. If it's too good, no one actually leave their computer. They just sit at the computer all day and play. Also, apparently the computer in 17 is supposed to kind of maintain other fields. So, not sure if it's true or not, haven't really been watching any of the videos, if the other field, if like all the fields are planted and the game kind of like grows and maintains them. I don't know if any of you guys know or can confirm or deny that. Because if you're looking at out the windows here, everything's just empty fields, and that's kind of a buzzkill with 15. Stuff only grows if you actually own it and are farming it. So if everything's planted and you don't own the field or farm it, does the crop still wither? Or does it just kind of like go away and then replant itself? That's the million-dollar question. You know you're getting old when it's 8:30 and you're tired as heck. And I'm not even married or have kids. It's all downhill. Yeah, 25 is the changing up. Yeah, I feel like once I hit 25, everything just goes downhill. Anyways, guys, I'm probably going to end the video here. Packers are playing tonight, so thanks for watching.